Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 22, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, Company's Registration Department grants Certificate of Establishment of Iraqi Deposit Insurance Company, 22nd October, 2019. The Central Bank of Iraq announces to the Department of Companies Registration at the Ministry of Commerce the Certificate of Establishment of the Iraqi Company to guarantee deposit/mixed contribution, in accordance with the provisions of Article 19 of the Companies Law No. 21. For the year 1997 amended, the Iraqi company was established to guarantee deposits with a contribution of 42 banks, and the number rose after the IPO session to 63 banks, including 7 government banks and 40 private Iraqi banks, and 16 Arab and foreign banks, in addition to 4 companies government and mixed, as well as the National Retirement Authority/State Pension Fund, where the capital of the company 100 billion dinars. It is noteworthy that the deposit guarantee companies found to support efforts in stabilizing the financial and banking system inside Iraq. Central Bank of Iraq, Information Office, October 22, 2019. Next article of interest. The Minister of Finance signs a Memorandum of Understanding in Washington with the World Bank. Baghdad Morning, Tuesday, October 22, 2019. Deputy Prime Minister and Finance Minister Fuad Hussein signed a Memorandum of Understanding MOU with the World Bank on Monday. The Deputy Prime Minister for Economic Affairs and Minister of Finance headed the delegation of the Republic of Iraq to Washington, which included several advisors and general directors in addition to the Ambassador of Iraq to Washington, in the annual roundtable on Iraq for the Bank and the IMF international representatives of the United States, the United Kingdom, Germany, France, Japan and Saudi Arabia. The minister added that the Iraqi government is determined to continue reforms and overcome economic and institutional challenges and determined to create an effective and efficient private sector that can contribute to national development and create jobs for young people and contribute to the diversification of the economy. Hussein signed a memorandum of understanding with the World Bank outlining the future cooperation framework between the two sides and will form the basis of a long-term partnership agreement, pointing to cooperation in implementing reforms in the financial sector, economic governance and reforms in making the business and investment environment suitable and attractive to local and international investors. The memorandum also refers to cooperation in the implementation of reforms to develop the agricultural sector and food industries through the introduction of modern technology to facilitate access to global markets and facilitate access to bank financing with the development of governance in the field of regulating the gas sector and the organization of the work of the private sector in this sector. He pointed out that the memorandum in the electricity sector, including improved financial sustainability through the organization of wage collection and controls to protect consumers from poor classes, provided that the government to form a ministerial committee of the economic sector to oversee the implementation of the reforms provided for in the memorandum understanding. Next article of interest, to implement the demands of the demonstrators, launch financial allocations for service projects in Babylon within 24 hours, October 21, 2019, 1357. Trade Minister Mohammed Alani, Monday, the launch of financial allocations for the implementation of service projects in Babylon within 24 hours. A statement of the trade received Euphrates News a copy that the Minister of Commerce representative of the Prime Minister in the Ministerial Committee to implement the demands of the demonstrators Mohammed Hashim Alani arrived today to the city of Hilla in the province of Babylon accompanied by MP Salam al-Shamari, Undersecretary of the Ministry of Housing and Municipalities and the Governor of Babylon and Director General Sectors in the Ministry of Planning, the representative of the Prime Minister's Office and the Director General of Commercial and Financial Control in the Ministry of Commerce. He added, the minister, immediately after his arrival to Babylon, held a meeting with the Governor of Babylon and his aides and heads of service departments, during which they discussed the mechanisms of implementing service projects and launching financial allocations related to operational and investment budgets and projects related to liberated areas, as well as problems facing the implementation of projects in an urgent manner. He pointed out that a dialogue was held with a number of demonstrators regarding the implementation of their demands and the preparation of implementation plans directly, pointing out that Ani conducted a tour of service projects in the province accompanied by a number of deputies from the province and the Deputy Minister of Housing and Municipalities and representative of the Prime Minister's office, where he visited Bridge et al. And a number of secondary and main streets. The statement pointed out that the visit comes to see the reality of the province and listen to the demands of the demonstrators directly. The minister announced, according to the statement, the launch of financial allocations for service projects and infrastructure in the province of Babylon. During a meeting with the Undersecretary of the Ministry of Planning and the representative of the Prime Minister to discuss the demands of demonstrators in the province of Babylon and address the problems faced by the province. The statement quoted Alani as stressing the importance of launching all financial allocations planned in the general budget for 2019, as well as making all efforts to address the problems facing youth through the implementation of the reform package decided by the Council of Ministers to accommodate youth initiatives and the establishment of small projects supported by the government financially and morally. He added, "The next stage requires more efforts that serve the aspirations of our young people and provide them with a decent life, both through attracting initiatives and providing financial support for them, as well as absorbing those capabilities through training, qualifying and preparing them to set up projects in different service disciplines, as well as addressing housing problems." During the initiative of the government in the distribution of land, which was launched in a number of provinces while the work continues to sort other areas with the aim of distributing them to our dear people, he pointed out, "The demands of the people of the province of Babylon are important and necessary to improve the reality of services that affect the lives of citizens and fight corruption and choose the right person in the right place, most of which falls within the priorities of the government program announced by the Prime Minister and approved by the House of Representatives, and the government has achieved a very wide steps and we are working now. The time frame for implementing the reform package approved by the Council of Ministers in the recent period has been reduced." Alani stressed the importance of forming a law enforcement force that deals with demonstrations in a way different from what happened in previous demonstrations, especially as a high-level ministerial committee set up by the government has verified the attacks that have taken place on demonstrators. The Minister of Commerce called the people of Babylon province to cooperate in solving all the problems facing the province, especially as the demands of the demonstrators were transferred to the Council of Ministers and there are mechanisms to develop appropriate solutions, especially those related to the problems of youth and find jobs and fight administrative and financial corruption and launch financial allocations for the establishment of projects SOA as well as address the housing problem. Next article of interest. Work is a mechanism for new incomes with full-time salary. 22nd October, 2019, the Ministry of Labor and Social Affairs, on Tuesday, it is looking to prepare a new mechanism for the inclusion of a certain full-time in order to expand the coverage of the persons entitled to the salaries of the segment circle. Issam Abdul Latif El-Tamimi, Director of the Ministry of Persons with Disabilities and Special Needs, said in a statement to the official newspaper Al-Sabah that the ministry is working to prepare a mechanism for the new inclusion of the Law of Persons with Disabilities No. 38 of 2013 and the facilities provided to the disabled. Al-Tamimi added, "The ministry is working through this mechanism to simplify the procedures provided by the Commission for People with Disabilities in ways to enable the segment to be beneficial in the community," noting that the Commission has prepared the technical, administrative and financial proactive measures for the first batch of new beneficiaries in Baghdad and the province is launched by the middle of this month. Their salaries were distributed through the MasterCard who completed their medical reports during the first half of this year. Al-Tamimi called on the beneficiaries of the salary of a full-time nominee in Baghdad and the governorates of Rashid bank card holders who could not receive their dues to review the Information Technology Department at the authorities' headquarters in Baghdad for the beneficiaries in the capital, while the beneficiaries of the governorates will review the divisions of the authority according to each governorate. Next article of interest. Trump talks about a preliminary deal with China and is optimistic he will sign soon. October 22, 2019, 1536. U.S. President Donald Trump has spoken of progress in drafting an initial trade agreement with China, likely to be signed next month. Trump remains optimistic about the chances of Beijing and Washington reaching a mini deal, announced earlier this month, In a sign of improvement in easing the escalation over the devastating trade war between the two countries, Trump said at the White House, "We believe we will be able to sign a complete document with China on the first phase." U.S. Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer said efforts to forge the deal ahead of the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Summit in Chile next month were on track, although there are still some things that have not been finalized. "Our goal is to finish the first phase of the agreement before your departure to Chile," Lighthizer told Trump. Trump said he expected the initial agreement to be signed on the sidelines of the summit when he meets Chinese President Xi Jinping. Although little detail has been given about the mini-deal, it includes China's increased purchases of U.S. agricultural products, as well as intellectual property, financial services and currency exchange, according to the White House. Trump said on Monday that the Chinese were starting to buy. Next article of interest. Parliament sets next Saturday the date of its session to discuss the demands of the demonstrators. Baghdad where date, October 22, 2019, 2042. The General Secretariat of the House of Representatives confirmed the date of the next Parliament session. According to a statement received where a copy of it, the presidency of the Council of Representatives has agreed in agreement with the heads of the blocs to hold meetings for the month of October and in accordance with the rules of procedure of the Council, and to hold 8 meetings per month, taking into account the dates of the visit of the martyrs of the martyrs Imam Hussein. It accordingly, the next session, as scheduled, will be held on Saturday, 26 of this month, and will be devoted to follow up the demands of the demonstrators, and to discuss the final government report on the investigation of attacks on demonstrators, and the presence of a number of executives. He stressed that no response to the presidency of the House of Representatives until now any legal request to hold an emergency session. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.